Welcome back.
Nick and Lex here.
Hey everyone.
How's it going, guys? So tonight we're going to do another reaction for Mauricio.
Yeah.
And this is going to be by Mark Isham. Mm-hmm. And it's called Songs of the Flying Fish. I've never heard of this artist. Have you?
Me neither. I have never heard of him before. I'm like looking at the artwork. It looks super.
It looks like jazz.
Yeah.
And knowing Mauricio.
Uh-huh. Exactly. Yeah, he's done obviously lots of Pat Metheny, some Michael Franks. Mm-hmm. So I'm kind of expecting something in that vein. Yeah, definitely. Which is absolutely
which is great.
Very welcome.
We love jazz. We love jazz. So let's get into
it. I'm super excited to get started.
It's short. We will pause just so it's easier to edit. So I'm gonna try and count the beats or count the time and then pause it in a section where it doesn't affect the song too mm-hmm. much, and then we continue.
Okay. Yeah, unless it's like super in the middle of something.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, we just did one in Spanish and we literally paused like a minute before the ending and it was just like. Like,
yeah,
it's kind of like, but yeah, we had
but
to.
We can maybe work something out. We'll see. Okay.
Thank you. Because otherwise, I'm just gonna be like at the end. I want to I now have my thoughts together.
Yes, yes, yes.
So if I was a film director, I would use this. I know you want to say this, the same things, but I, like, it's very dreamy. I feel that, you know, Hollywood, the 80s, like, risky business vibe. But it's, I see, almost see, like, New York City with the Twin Towers still intact,
and, like,
you know.
Steam coming out of and the sewers.
Yes, and I still see, like, you know, I see the Brooklyn Bridge and you know, the life of New York City. And, like, that's what I feel when I hear this music. It's very dreamlike and very, very, it sounds very 80s, like the drums, you know.
Yeah, and this was 1990, so it definitely does sound like
it has
late
that 80s, 90s vibe,
like, going away.
And sounds like a soundtrack of a, like, a film, like Copland or you know, something like Tarantino could have done.
Yeah.
Maybe in the early days, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, it gives me certainly, like, a vibe like Miami Vice.
Of
maybe
course.
Not too much.
Because it's like that cool, like, jazzy sax.
Yeah.
Like,
it's like a sexy, you know, like, steamy.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of like,
exactly.
You know?
Exactly. It's nice.
I love it.
I really
love
enjoy it.
I love it to death. Yeah. But it's not like Kenny G. It's like serious. You know, it's like.
It's very talented, but very, like, cool.
And it has that. And then the bass and. It's just very good. It's really cool.
I love it.
I love it.
Yes, definitely. Me too. I agree with everything you said.
But I love that I can see these images while I hear the music. Like, you know, it has me. Sometimes music doesn't need lyrics at all. I'm a very instrumental music guy, so I can visualize all this stuff very easily.
I know.
Like Chinatown, you know. But then it kind of got away from Chinatown because it's more in the 80s and 90s.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
Electric drums and, you know, keyboards.
I love it.
Stuff.
I love the sound.
Really cool. Thank you, Mauricio.
Thank you, Mauricio. I rewound it just a few seconds, so let's
continue.
Yeah,
it's just like a minute left, but let's just enjoy it.
Okay.
Thank you, guys. Very nice. I loved how they these lead guitars were layered in there. And sometimes a lot of people are like, you've heard this before.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, oh my God. Like, just because I know how to predict something. I mean, if a guy plays like a lick like that. If he stops there, then it's musically incorrect. There has to be a resolution.
Yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
Like, that's
always
why sometimes
like
I can play along and I can predict the music, because if they don't play, then it doesn't make sense, you know?
Exactly.
Especially with music like this that is more structured.
Yes.
So
linear.
Not linear, but just like it does, it makes sense that comes, because it's just harmonically makes sense that comes when you study music. So I just wanted to point that out, because I do that a lot, because even with songs that have like that are very complex, I know kind of like what's coming, because it's just, it makes sense.
Right.
You know?
And as a musician, I think that's what you would
that's
do.
That's not what I would do. And then they do it and I'm like, thank God they did it.
Yeah,
it makes
exactly.
it so much better, because
this was so cool. Thank you so much, Mauricio. I'm this is an artist that we'll definitely be wanting to get more into. We'd never heard him before. We literally just discovered a new jazz artist. That feels so awesome.
And I love that it did have keyboards, like, you know, like synthy.
Uh-huh.
And the bass was also kind of like synthy, and the drums. And it does have some electric guitar. Mm-hmm. Not too much. So like he kept the trumpet as a main instrument. Yes. It was beautiful. Very nice.
Absolutely. Yeah. I loved it. Thank you so, so much. Let us know, you guys, if this was your first time listening to it, what did you think? Did you know Mark Isham before? Who else should we be checking out? Always leave your suggestions. We, you know, love to take a look at the comments and see what you guys say about the artist trivia. Thank you for sharing this with us. We hope to see you in the next video.
Thank you, guys. Take care. Bye.